Imagine you'd have a dream. Imagine you'd perfectly know, deep inside your soul, what you want to do with your life. And then imagine you would just ignore all doubts and go for it, because you know it's gonna make you happy.
Buying a sailboat is the one thing, but being officially allowed to sail it is another. In Germany, you need a sportboat license and a radio license. An official sailing license is not required, unless you want to charter a boat. We had the exam for our sportboat license on the Dortmund-Ems Canal in Münster.
Einschlagen, Seeseite, rückwärts fahren. Wenn man dann weit genug weg ist, wieder einschlagen und vorwärts fahren.
But we lived in Hagen, in a cozy little apartment by the river, which we had furnished really nice during the 6 months we were living there.
Wir haben hier unser Schlafzimmer. Da mache ich auch meine Videos. Also hier mache ich dann hinter der Tür quasi die Greenscreen-Aufnahmen. Hier an meinem Schreibtisch schneide ich dann alles. Und dann haben wir natürlich immer noch unser Badezimmer. Da hat sich nicht so viel getan, außer dass die Pileas natürlich riesengroß geworden sind in dem halben Jahr. Dann haben wir hier unser Wohnzimmer. Da haben wir richtig viel dran gemacht. Also wir haben jetzt ein schönes Sofa und wir haben eine große Regalwand. Und vor allem kann man bei der Regalwand eine Leinwand runterfahren. Da muss man einfach nur kurz hier auf den Knopf drücken und zack, kommt die Leinwand fürs Heimkino raus. Hier drüben haben wir den Beamer und dann können wir hier richtig cool immer abends Netflixen, wenn wir mal Zeit dafür haben. Hier geht es dann weiter ins Esszimmer. Da haben wir einen schönen Tisch, unser Aquarium und eine ganz gemütliche Küche.
The weekend of the motorboat license exam was pretty much the most chaotic weekend in the recent years. Our apartment in Hagen was affected by the heavy rains in Germany and was completely flooded shortly before the exam.
Sollen wir gucken, ob sich das irgendwo verhakt?
Ein Kanu!
On the day of the flooding, we wanted to put all our stuff on eBay. At that point, no one could have guessed that only a few hours later, the rain would fill our entire basement to the ceiling and reach a height of 30 centimeters in our apartment as well.
Jo, unser Haus ist das Weiße.
You could watch the water rising and rising, and the worst thing was that nobody knew when it would stop. When we realized that the water would definitely flood the buildings, we built dams together with our neighbors and moved our belongings to the second floor.
When the first dams broke, we knew pretty quickly that we had absolutely no chance. Within a very short time, the water was up to the ceiling in the basement and then pressed through the basement ceiling into our apartment.
Thank you.
The next day we saw the dimension of the flooding. We couldn't believe that this actually happened. But we were lucky in misfortune. Other people were affected much worse. We have lost only a few pieces of our furniture and had to move out 6 weeks earlier than planned. From other people, the flooding has taken everything, and our thoughts are with them.
Every end is also a beginning. Actually, our plan was to move directly from Hagen to the boat. But because of the flooding, we really had to move out kind of overnight, and for the time being, we both stayed with our parents in Münster. We drove back and forth between Hagen and Münster for a few days to help with the cleanup and to save what could be saved from our belongings and furniture. And then we focused on the move to the boat and worked through one to-do list after the other. There was still much work between us and our life on the boat. Cutting mattresses, selling all our belongings, passing the radio license exam, and a big wedding in Czech Republic. But about all that, we'll tell you next time. And of course, we'd be really glad if you'd be in for it again.